At some point, you're going to meet your old self. And your old self, you know you found him or her when it's telling you you can't, or you don't need to, or this is too hard. And then that's where we get to choose. Is it who I know I am, or who I was? A little bit longer, a little bit stronger, changes everything. You just feel that level of accomplishment.
I had it in my head that if I was gonna be a single mom, I needed to be strong and I needed to not back down from anything.
I wanna create so much more for people. I wanted to make it so that they aged really, really well. That they have more energy during the day. That they live a more vibrant life. Now, do you get a better bicep in the workout? Maybe, and that's great, and that's frosting on the cake, but that's not what we're in there to do.
Fitness, one of the hottest new workouts.
Orange Theory, this stuff works.
The more you put into Orange Theory, the more life you're gonna get out of it.
A global fitness product.
New studios opening every day in every city.
South Florida resident Ellen is the creator.
Renowned exercise expert, Ellen Latham.
Ellen Latham.
Ellen Latham.
Ellen Latham.
What defines my success is what my father taught me. How are you contributing out there? I really got that message clearly from him, and that's all I wanted to do. I grew up in Niagara Falls, New York. In our neighborhood, everyone's lawn was pristine, and ours looked like a dirt pit. And that was because we always held the kickball games, the baseball games on our front lawn grass. And my father had no problem with that. My father was a phys ed teacher, local football coach. Everyone knew him. They called him Coach when you were in the grocery store. Hey, Coach. He was living his purpose. He said, whatever you do, make sure you're passionate about it, because you're gonna spend a lot of time doing it. And the icing on the cake is if you could feel that you're contributing to other human beings with it. Success is defined in different ways. For him, he probably never made more than $50,000 a year. And he felt he was the most successful man walking the earth. So there's little Ellen. What do you suppose she's thinking of right there in major contemplation of life? I guess I started early. Mom and Dad, oh, these pictures were so small then. Me graduating from college, University of Buffalo. My pride and joy, my little Evan. Love this little guy. Who got bigger. Oh boy, now we're talking the aerobic days. Oh, that is so frightening. Fitness in the 80s was the best. Giant hair, thong leotards. I'm going back to the Jane Fonda leg warmer days. It was a very scary, scary time, but a wonderful time. Aerobics was huge. I would teach classes with 50 people behind me.
We're talking the leg curl.
You I just got a job as an exercise physiologist.
Now hold the weight, I want you to hammer behind you.
It was my dream job.
What body type are you? Myself, mesomorph body built. Madonna falls into that category.
New research is telling us that at least 20 minutes of aerobic activity will make a difference in burning fat.
Morning. Thank you for
joining
us.
Thank you for having me. This is really a and then one day, my boss calls me into his office and basically fires me.
What?
At that time, a single parent, I was devastated. How was I going to make money, keep my house, support my son? You could do a lot of things, retreat, hide under the bed. My father very much lived by the sports psychology theory. You can momentum shift up or you can momentum shift down. Momentum shifting up is focusing on what you have and not what you don't have. What is working for you in your life? I'm a pretty good group X instructor. And then I just got this Pilates certification. And then I started taking some people that I met in the gym and did Pilates out of a spare room in my house.
There was people coming in all morning and at night. It started out as one an hour and then it was two an hour. I don't know what I was amazed more, her fitting two Pilates machines in this small room or her actually running a phenomenally successful business out of it.
I started building, then I started developing real strong confidence. I got my confidence back. And that started my path to open up this Pilates studio. My members weren't quite getting the results they wanted. I kept hearing this frustration of not having the fat burning workout they would like. So I decided I would move my studio to a bigger space and I would create that workout. As an exercise physiologist, I knew the types of things I would ideally like in that room. And I opened up the doors and people were getting incredible results.
I am a coach at Orangetheory Fitness. Each of my days start an hour before I have to be anywhere, so usually that's 4 a.m. I'm all about like the discipline of I don't want to do it, so it's probably best for me. I meditate for 30 minutes. After that, I have like my morning routine. I write my intentions for every day. Then I'm heading over to the studio. I know what's possible from the tear that I've cried on the treadmill from wanting something to the power I felt when it was like my body screamed stop and I gave it one more. And how I left feeling like I was unstoppable beyond just that treadmill that day.
Queen B, good morning.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
What I love about Orangetheory is like it's group fitness, but with that personal trainer or that personal touch. I approach class like you're the only one here and I'm gonna give you everything I have. Whether it's, you know, some of our more experienced athletes or it's someone who's just getting started, even playing field. You put the heart rate monitor on and it's you against you. Gratitude leads everything in my life. We call it the G vitamin, the gratitude vitamin. As I tell my class, if everything in the world is going bad, then opportunity, be grateful that you're still here to notice it. I was raised in Carson, Compton area, so definitely a LA, California kid. Gangs were bad in our area. We got our windows shot out of our house. And I was just getting in a lot of trouble. When I was 15, my cousin Daryl, which was like my brother, got killed. He was the first one I lost close to me. So it's that shock of like, okay, I'm not gonna see him again. And it was hard. I definitely went through a grieving period that I kept away from most. I was gonna figure out how to find happy. Sports was something that allowed me to lose the world for a little bit. Sports gave me something to just strive for. Football was the first place that I started to value myself and believe that I could be worth something to somebody. I played football at UNLV. I ended up playing pro arena ball for a couple seasons. My last season, I had a lot of head injuries. I got scared because I couldn't put my sentences together. As you age, things start to come into perspective. I had labeled myself as an athlete, and that was my identity. And without that, it was like, who am I? It took a while to find that drive again. I reignited it through fitness. I wake up every single day to do one thing, and it's beat who I was yesterday.
I kept like looking over at Coach Steve and my butt just kept getting higher and I'm like, okay, this is fine, this is fine. He's not gonna see. And then this Steve is like, put your butt down, you can do it. I know, like how? Fitness was always a means to an end for me. So it was about losing weight or looking a certain way. Something to do with my physical appearance. And it was only when I got to Orange Theory that I realized that fitness means so much more. It's more about well-being and health and your ability to do things outside of that room other than perch on a chair and look a certain way. I work in the pharmaceutical industry for a company that makes heartburn medication for babies.
Okay, come here. Ready? Watch your head.
And I am a mom to an almost 3-year-old daughter, Lorelai. We're just kind of like the gruesome twosome.
You think you should fix the blocks?
Yeah. Just like really close friends. I'm already getting emotional thinking about her. It's just the two of us.
Yeah.
I grew up in a little town. The only way you could tell your house apart from the neighbors was the color. I always wanted something more. I wanted to see the world and have the pride of ownership of my life. I just busted my butt and I think I pestered my way into Tulane University to their PhD program. They sent me to Costa Rica for a couple of years. That was where I met my daughter's father. This is all a girl could want. Like I'm living, literally living my dream. His mental health started going. So he was very short and very emotional and he would have these outbursts that were scary. I didn't tell anybody that I was unhappy, that I was scared. I found myself hiding from him. I guess it was sort of like how they say when you put a lobster in a pot of cold water and you slowly turn up the heat, like it doesn't realize it's dying. And that's what the abuse was like for me. It started so slow. And by the end, I just couldn't, I didn't know what was happening to me until I told somebody else. My friend said, we see it. We see what he does to you. Like he controls you. You have to get out. They got me an emergency passport and in a couple days later, I was on a plane coming home. And I had to start all over. I left everything. I sold everything. I have nothing here but my family.
Fitness is taking data to the next level.
The theory behind Orange Theory is heart rate.
The science is a heart rate-based interval training. Orange Theory has just taken it to like a way bigger level.
Monitors track your levels as trainers drive you from the orange zone to red and back to orange again.
Shannon, you look like you got that intense look on your face there.
Today's the day. Today is the day.
Every day is the day.
Obviously, we want to play off that.
Thanks, Shannon.
So we're just talking some of the theory stuff more. Mm-hmm. So ideally, give me a 2-minute base. And give me a 30-second all out. When I designed the workout, base was me trying to build stamina in our members, aerobic stamina. The push, we're looking for a little higher push, a little bit more horsepower into that cell. And then that all out where we want that uncomfortable lactic acid tolerance to improve. Push is good. Sometimes people get confused about push. Push is good. I need to get that heart rate over 84% for at least 12 minutes. We call those splat points. I need to put power in your body. You lose power as we age. That's why you're rowing. I need to do muscle work. That's why you're using the TRX and equipment in the weight room. The science of the workout really assures that you're going to get results, giving you more life.
Pretty amazing.
Jerome, my partner, his wife came into my studio, and she kept insisting to me to talk to her husband. I end up talking to Jerome and Dave.
Dave and I did believe in it after we took the workout. If we could get people to stick with us, we had something.
Nobody was supportive that it was going to work. The common knowledge is everything in fitness is already there. So why are you guys trying to recreate and do something different?
We all heard you're crazy. There's so many fitness concepts out there. What is Orange Theory? What is this theory? I was a single parent, a woman, and 54 years old. I mean, people start thinking about retirement then.
So after about 6 or 7 months, we knew that people were staying with us. They kept getting stronger and stronger.
And we were in the studio a ton and talking to people, obviously, when they come out of the class and just being like, you know, holy shit, this is something special.
Happy Wednesday, everybody. So it is that time to rock and roll. We know today is a big day. With that said, best effort is all that matters. Let's burn. Good morning. Good morning. Let's go, Kate, Michelle, Almighty, what? Allison, the building, Julie, Jenna.
When people step into my class, the first thing I want them to do is know they matter.
Papa Joe, Mighty Joe, good to see you, sir. With that said, Mighty E, let's burn. In 3, 2, 1.
The mission is the same, like let's together become better.
It is all about power. The highest watts you can sustain.
One of the ways that we're very unique is capturing each individual's member's data. To use technology within the workout gives the data, gives the heart rate feedback so they can truly optimize that hour.
I said, that's a girl's gym, not going. And then I said, I need to at least go inside and see what's going on. They make me run, I don't like to run. They make me row, nobody likes to row. And then the lifting happens too.
3, 2, 1, bring it down.
This is what you should be doing.
Ready?
You got it.
And you, my dear, yeah. Totally do 20s next time.
Ah, you caught me.
You'll take someone who comes in for their first class. You know, maybe they're a little intimidated and they don't know what they're doing, or maybe they've never done a certain exercise. You're watching them get stronger and faster. Sometimes people are losing body fat and they're gaining muscle and confidence. That's a huge piece of it too. It's not just what you can see, right? It's what's on the inside. And yeah, it's pretty cool to watch people grow that way.
Here we go, 1 minute left in Orange.
I was almost 300 pounds. I was on the bench and I couldn't get up. I'm super embarrassed. And there was Joe, arm hand out, and he just picked me up and he's like, let's just keep going. You always challenge yourself here. I couldn't do it without this place and without Joe and without the team here.
You know who Joe is and what he brings to the table. And I connected and I said, this is fire. He was checking in with me, kept me on pace, and I was exhausted, which is what I wanted.
Look over at the person next to you. Tell them we made it. Way to work, Party 45 crew. Congratulations. That is huge. I'm so proud of you. That is awesome. Yes, like text that, post that. Awesome work. Way to get after a beast. What? You are into the sub eights? Stop it. Awesome work today, Miss Donna.
Well, let's look and see if we can see the ducky. Where is he? Is he over there near the rock?
No.
No?
With the combination of the therapy, she was doing outpatient therapy, and then she started to go to the gym, and I think that all of that just helped her to gain herself back and be the person that she was before.
Can I put the pee on it?
Yes, that's absolutely a great idea.
I was scared and stressed and anxious and depressed.
I put the water on it.
But it started this journey of acknowledging the facts. And seeing things for how they really were, and kind of taking back my own power.
Did you PR?
I did PR.
Okay, then you're welcome.
I PR'd by 0.5.
See?
This was like a place for me, a numbered station that was for me. I go in there and I feel like I am worthy to take up the space I take up, and I'm worthy of being part of the group.
And, you know, I think it's like
what got me going back was the community. Everybody said, you did it, so you're coming back Thursday, right? And I've never felt healthier. I've never had more muscle mass. I've never been stronger. I've never been faster. I've never gotten sick less. I've never slept better. This whole experience has just completely shifted my perspective of what health and fitness actually is.
I've taught group fitness for over 40 years. What was important to me was that everyone felt validation. And I was very aware of that when I created this workout. When we get up in the morning, isn't the goal to exit the day feeling better about ourselves? That's a great way to live. Well, it's also a great way to exercise.
Good morning. Listen, all of you guys who have been here from day one, you know, 12 years ago, this studio opened up. Many of you have been with me longer than that. Been with me 15, 20, I think the longest, right?
30.
Hillary, Susan, 30 years. My appreciation for what you give every day is beyond any words. I love y'all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's one. So with the arms.
So I've been with Amanda now for 6 years.
Feet together.
Met her back in LA, and she is going to be my bride.
It's okay, just keep going. Just keep going.
She's beautiful. She's smart. She's funny, and the number one thing is, like, the laughter.
I hope we're all laughing together with me.
At the end of the day, there's always laughing. And we have that equal agreement that we'll stand for each other and stand with each other.
I've never seen Joe happier than when he teaches Orange Theory.
Left, right, you didn't come with me.
To be able to touch 36 lives in an hour, it is his calling. I mean, he's impacted so many people's lives in that studio, and it's all because he cares.
Wow, so good to see you.
I tell the members after class, some will tell me, oh, great class. I'm like, you don't understand. I just got more out of that class than you did. If you could take the energy of an Orange Theory class and duplicate it into our planet, into our neighborhoods, you're talking about, you know, a world-changing environment.
Good to see you, Kim Almighty, Allison the Great, Miss Sherry, good to see you.
Perfect. The only thing we have control over in our life is the effort we put into things, which in turn creates great influence. To think big, to be the best they can be, huge responsibility. I kind of take it serious.
The sense of being able to accomplish something, feel better, have more energy, have more confidence. It's really empowering people for the million different things that they want to go out and do.
And the amount of lives that were changed Every day we talk to people and hear different stories.
And to be able to like have this huge platform of, what are we gonna have, about a million members? So a million human beings have had their life affected. There is a woman in Japan right now that is doing this workout that, my goodness, is healthier, has a stronger heart, maybe has more energy as she goes home with her family. I will never meet her, but I definitely carry her inside of me.
If you can find the smallest thing to be grateful for, maybe it's just a breath, or maybe it's grateful that you can still say help, it gets me through.
Fitness is about feeling healthy and powerful and like I can keep up with my daughter and that I never have to tell her, no, mommy can't do that. You know, like I want to be the one showing her how to scramble up the tree.
You know, what are we supposed to be doing here? We're supposed to be just being the best we can so that kind of emits out to others. And look what could happen.